Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Thursday, SpaceX successfully launched the Starlink 57 mission on a Falcon 9 rocket.
One, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the fourth time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing burn.
And there's confirmation that the stage 1 landing burn has started in preparation for touchdown on our drone ship Of Course I Still Love You, which is currently
stage 2 FTS has saved.
Currently stationed in the Pacific Ocean.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
And there's confirmation that our Falcon 9 first stage has successfully launched and landed for the fourth time. Today's landing marks our 202nd overall landing of an orbital class rocket, including Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy missions.
Nominal orbit insertion.
Then, the following day on Friday, SpaceX launched the Starlink 512 mission successfully.
1, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the eighth time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 2 is in terminal guidance.
Stage 1 landing burn.
There's that confirmation that stage 1 landing burn has started in preparation for a touchdown on our drone ship. Just read the instructions. Keep an eye out for those landing legs that are scheduled to deploy just moments before landing.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
And there we go. Falcon 9 has successfully landed, marking the eighth landing for this booster.
This coming week, we can hopefully expect another Falcon 9 launch. The Euclid mission is currently scheduled for Saturday, July 1st at 3:11 PM UTC or 11:11 AM EDT. I wanted to share a tweet related to hardware recovery that's rarely talked about. For years now, SpaceX have been recovering fairings. This tweet says in relation to the latest Starlink launch, fairings deployed. Today's mission marks our first 10th flight of a fairing half. There was a tweet posted related to the launch of the next Axia mission. It says, according to NASA's internal schedule, the Axiom 3 crew mission to the ISS is slipping into the first quarter of 2024. When talking about Starship and Starlink on Twitter recently, Musk gave information about Starlink. This tweet says, Musk dodges a question in this ongoing conversation about doing an IPO for Starlink, given renewed rumors about that, it would not be legal for me to speculate. Heading to Boca Chica, the work around the orbital launch mount has been continuing. SpaceX was seen working on the booster quick disconnect hoses. There were recently a load of propellant deliveries for some Starship testing. In the production yard, here's a look at the progress on the new high bay building. Here's a view of other construction work going on around the production site. The work on the expansion of the Star Factory building is continuing. In addition to that Starlink tweet from Jeff Faust, he posted more with information from Musk on Starship. The first one says, Musk said SpaceX has made a late-breaking change to the Starship Super Heavy stage separation, switching to a hot staging approach where the ship lights its engines while a few booster engines are still firing. He estimates an approximately 10% increase in payload performance with this. In another tweet, it says that will involve an extension to the booster with vents for the ship exhaust and shielding to the top of the booster, he says. He estimates both the vehicle and pad upgrades will be complete in about 6 weeks. Recall in late April he expected to be ready to fly in 2 months. Then the final tweet in the thread says, Musk says they have made improvements to Raptor engines as well. He believes the next Starship Super Heavy launch will have much higher chances of success, estimating 60% at one point. There was a booster aft section that was seen lifted and moved in the mega bay. During the week, SpaceX was seen once again attempting some engine testing of Starship 25. SpaceX performed a spin prime test on the Ship 25 Raptor engines. SpaceX posted a tweet about recent testing of the Starship 25 prototype. They said Ship 25 completed a flight-like chill and spin of the Raptor engine pump, stopping just before engine ignition. As a result of the test, cryogenic liquid oxygen formed a visible cloud beneath the ship. This checked out vital systems in advance of the upcoming static fire. Taking a look at the upcoming road and beach closures, there are some dates for this coming week. Currently, there are possible closures for tomorrow, Monday 26th, Tuesday 27th and Wednesday 28th. As always, I have to say thanks to Nick Answeeney for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.